Former RBI Governor Raghuram Rajan has said today that farm loan waivers should not form part of poll promises, and he's written to the EC that such issues should be taken off the table. He was speaking at the release of the economic agenda report, which he has co-authored. Take a look.
It goes without saying that as we grow, as we become a more developed economy, we have to think about these institutions which can help guide our growth. And that certainly emphasizes the strength of the institution and the independence, the operational independence of the institution under an overall guiding framework. Now, I think both what people misunderstand is this issue of operational independence. That means you're given your marching orders by the will of the people, the government, not just of the day but of previous days. But then within that framework, you have to carry out your mandate, and you're given the independence to carry out that mandate. Sometimes people say, oh, no, the government has to determine both the overall mandate plus your specific what you do operationally. That doesn't make any sense, because then the institution is not doing what the professionals in that institution are supposed to do. I've said forever, even written a note, a letter to the election commissioner saying these should be taken off the table. I mean, certainly there is reason to think about farm distress, but the question of whether the flows to farmers is best affected by waiving loans, after all, there's only a subset of farmers who get those loans, and so it often goes to the best connected rather than the most poorly off. And second, it obviously creates enormous problems for the fiscal of the state once those waivers are done. And I think the unfortunately, it inhibits investment down the line. Now, to the question of whether there are fiscal transfers needed for farmers and whether they need to, that is certainly an issue that needs to be debated, but also investment is needed in agriculture. And you can see the set of policies that we recommend is about how to make agriculture itself a vibrant industry as opposed to an industry which needs to be propped up through transfers. And I think our farmers deserve no less, that we need to create the environment in which they can be a vibrant force. And I would say more resources are definitely needed. Whether loan waivers are the best, I think, is highly questionable.
And don't forget that Raghuram Rajan will be speaking to Pranoy Roy this weekend, and that's where you can catch the interview. Alisha covered that release of the report for us. Alisha, we saw him somewhat refer to that meet to what's happening in, you know, talking about institutions as such. Any other references to the huge RBI controversy?
Well, Sunetra, journalists, you know, present there, definitely wanted to take that opportunity to ask Mr. Raghuram Rajan about the question of the day, which really was about, the independence of the RBI now that it has a new governor and the older one resigned over spars with the government, you know, relating to what it does with the excess capital reserves, which the government feels that the central bank has. And about that, you know, there were several economists there. We spoke to them, and it turns out that most of these, reserves, as Mr. Amartya Lahiri also pointed out to me earlier in the day, are largely notional. So what the government wants out of the RBI now is probably fulfill the various promises that it's made to the electorate, also inflate its growth so that, you know, and also increase spending so that growth can be inflated. And Mr. Rajan, of course, did not specifically refer to the RBI, but when he was put the question, he did say that all institutions in the country must not forget that operational independence is very important. And what he meant by operational independence was that, of course, that politics and the government of the day will give you what he said were marching orders. But what you do beyond that in how you operate and, you know, preserve your mandate is really something that should be done independently. So that's a reference that he did make to the RBI. And of course, When it comes to fiscal management also, he did say that, what was really important was that, we don't really simply look at inflating growth, but also ensuring that the benefits of this growth are equitable. And, the growth story that we're seeing in India is actually for everyone and not just a few people, and is not only driven by government spending, which it looks like it is being right now, Sunitra.